We are in module 6, where we are covering regression and interpolation. In lecture 6.1, we gave an introduction to regression and interpolation techniques. In lecture 6.2 and 6.3, we have covered linear and nonlinear regression techniques in MATLAB. In this lecture, we are going to cover techniques for doing interpolation. Specifically, we are going to talk of two interpolation techniques in MATLAB called spline and p-chip interpolation. Okay, so what are these two interpolation techniques? Spline is known as a cubic spline interpolation. So that's the command that we will use to obtain cubic spline interpolation. That's nothing but fitting the data with a cubic polynomial which satisfies certain properties so that we get an overall smooth curve that fits all the data that we have. The other option in MATLAB is known as piecewise cubic Hermite polynomial. We will take two examples to show spline and p-chip interpolation, and we will use these examples to demonstrate when is it advisable to use p-chip interpolation, and in all other conditions we are going to use spline interpolation. Okay, the syntax for both spline and p-chip are very similar to each other. The syntax for spline I'm giving over here. All you need to do to run p-chip is just to replace spline with p-chip, and you will be able to use p-chip instead of spline. The syntax is simple. Y interpolated, that means the output of the function spline is the interpolated dependent data that is given by spline, x data comma y data. X data is the independent data, y data is the dependent data. Okay, and so this is the data that we have in with us. Now we want to interpolate between some x values between these original data points. Okay, and that is given by xval. We will come to that example in a little bit. Okay, so spline and p-chip are two different interpolation techniques that we are going to cover in today's lecture. Let's consider the example of temperature variations in a day. This data was taken for temperature in Chennai on 30th of October. This starts with midnight of 29th of October and ends at midnight of 30th of October. And we have temperature data in degrees Celsius at various different times within the day on 30th of October. So we have temperature data at 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m. and so on. Let's say we wanted the data at 2:30 a.m. or 6:30 a.m. or let's say 10:15 a.m. and so on. Okay. In that case, we do not have this data directly available from the website. So what we are going to do is we are going to use an interpolation function in order to calculate the data at those intermediate points. Let's go to MATLAB and see how that works. Okay, so I've already created a file called interdiurnal t to have the data for us ready. Okay, so let's go and check what the data looks like. So at time 0, the temperature is 25.6. At time 1, it's 25.4. Okay. And at time 23 is 26.8. And time 24 is 26.1. So 26.8 and 26.1. Okay. Interpolating temperature values. So let's say we want the HI, let us say that contains the hours, the hours at which we want the values to be interpolated. So 2:30 a.m. is going to be 2.5, 6:30 a.m. is going to be 6.5, 10:15 a.m. is going to be 10.25. Let's say we also wanted the data at 5 p.m. Okay, this is just to check how our interpolation works. At 5 p.m., we expect our data to be exactly the same as what we have over here. So the last value should be equal to 31.8. So we will check whether that's what we get. Okay. And the interpolated values Ti are going to be nothing but spline let's go to the syntax, spline x data, y data. Our x data, that is the independent data, is in the vector h. The dependent data is in vector t. Keep in mind that the size of vector h and t are both 25. So they are row vectors of length 25. Okay, that is important. It's important that h and t are of the same size, and hi are the interpolated our values at which we want our interpolation to be done, and ti is going to be the temperature values at those points. So let's run this. Okay, and let's go and check what the values of hi and ti are. Okay, so at 2.5 hours, the temperature is approximately 25 degrees Celsius. At 2.5, temperature is approximately 25. At 6.5 hours, temperature is 26.13. At this point, the temperature is 26.13. At 10 hours, 15 minutes, the temperature is 30.9. And at 17 hours, that is at 5 p.m., temperature is exactly the same as data, which is 31.8. Okay, the temperature at this point is exactly the same as what the data shows over here. Okay, so these are the temperatures calculated at the intermediate data points using the spline interpolation. Okay, let's go on to another example. And this example is of a car moving on a busy Chennai street. Okay, so this is the car that is moving in front of the government hospital in Chennai, and there is a signal right in front of the government hospital. So the car takes 1.5 minutes to go from this end of the road to the other end of the road that we are currently monitoring. It's when it enters this particular road, the speed of the car is 45 kilometers per hour. It comes to a halt at the signal and its speed becomes zero. It stays as zero for something between 10 to 20 seconds. Okay, after which the car starts moving again and the car accelerates to go up to 55 kilometers per hour. Okay, so this is the data. Let's go to MATLAB and let's bring up the file which I have already created with this data. So this is the time and this is the speed. Okay, interpolation using spline. Okay, ti. Let's say we want our speeds at 5 seconds, 15 seconds, 25 seconds, 35 seconds, so on and so forth. So let's say 5 to 10 to 90. I could have also made it 85. That's not a problem. So the time values are going to be 5, 10, 15, 20. Sorry, the time values are going to be 5, 15, 25, 35, up to 85. Okay. The speed interpolated using spline is, the command is same as before, spline, independent data, dependent data, and the vector at which we want the interpolated values. Okay, so let's run this. Okay, so when we run, we now have the interpolated data in vectors ti and si. So ti, si, let's type this out. Okay, so at time 5, the speed is 45.37. So the speed has kind of slightly increased from 45 to 45.37 in this interpolated data. At 15, the speed has dropped to 13.9. At 15 seconds, the speed has dropped to 13.9. Now there is something interesting that happens. At 25, the interpolated value of speed shows -3.2. Okay. What that means is that between these two points, although we know for a fact that the car is stopped at that signal, so between these two points, the speed has to be zero, the interpolated value shows that the speed is non-zero. The reason for this is because spline tries to fit a smooth curve to all these data points. It tries to fit a smooth curve, and when it tries to do that, it gets the value between 20 and 30 to be negative. Okay, let's go and change this code a little bit. So between 5 and 90, we want the interpolated values at all data points. Okay, and we also want to plot them. So let's say we will plot our original data T, S, we will plot them as blue circles, let's say. Hold on. Okay, and we will plot, let's move this up here, and we will plot our interpolated values TI, SI as black line. Okay. And let's see what spline does. So in fact, why 5 to 90, let's go right from 0 to 90 in steps of 1. So the interpolated value SI is going to be speeds at 0 seconds, 1 seconds, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, and so on up to 90 seconds. Okay, so let's run this and see what we get. Okay, so this is the blue lines are the original data and black lines are the interpolated data. As you can see that the spline interpolates is the data in form of a smooth curve, and because this particular speed has dropped rapidly to zero and stayed at zero for a while, when we try to fit a smooth cubic spline on to this particular data, we get negative values between 20 to 30 seconds. Okay, now we know for a fact that the speed is not going to be negative because the car is not expected to go in the reverse direction. So that kind of constraint is actually there in that data. So let's say now we want that particular physical situation to be handled more gracefully. Under such situations, we will use the other interpolation formula, which is the P-chip interpolation formula. Okay, so let's see how we will use P-chip. Okay, what we said was the syntax is exactly the same. We just replace spline with P-chip. Okay, and that is exactly what we are going to do in MATLAB. So this is what we had written earlier. So let's just copy paste this interpolation using P-chip and SIPC equal to, instead of spline, P-chip. Okay, and let's just do this for TI from 5 to 90 in steps of 10. Okay, for now we don't need plot, so let's comment this out. Okay, and let's clear all, close all, and clear the screen. Oops, yeah, let's run this. Okay, yeah, we didn't need the figure plotting. Okay, so let's see what TI, SI were. This is what TI, SI were, and let's type TI and SIPC and see what they were. Okay, so let's focus on the point at which we got negative values of the speed. Okay, and that was 25 at time 25, the value of speed you were using the spline interpolation was minus 3.23, whereas using P-chip is 0. So P-chip maintains this kind of monotonicity in the data. What that means, we will come to that in a minute. But this particular expectation that the speed is not going to go below zero when the vehicle is at halt is maintained by the P-chip interpolation, whereas that is not maintained by the spline interpolation. At other data points, we have spline and P-chip behaving in more or less a similar manner. There is some difference between the interpolated value, but that difference is not very significant. The most important difference comes in at this particular data point, where we want P-chip or we want the interpolation to match the requirement that when the vehicle comes to a halt, its speed is at zero. Okay, so let's plot this. Let's change this back using Control Z to get the data, to get the interpolated data at all points between 0 and 90. And let's plot this also. And plot SIPC. And let's plot it using red dashed line. Okay, so this is the new command that I have. Okay, I'm plotting TI versus SIPC as red dashed line. And that I will use to compare with this spline. Okay. Okay, let's clear everything. Okay. So this is what we have, and let us run this. Okay. So the blue circles are the original data points. The black line that you see over here is the spline interpolation that we have done earlier, and the red dashed line is the p-chip interpolation, the piecewise cubic Hamite interpolation. Now you see the difference between spline and p-chip. Okay, there's no difference, for example, or there is very little difference between these two points or between all of these points, but there is significant difference over here and over here. Okay, and the difference arises between p-chip and spline because of the following reason. What p-chip does is it maintains monotonicity. What that means is between these two data points, when we try to interpolate, the y value is always going to lie between these two y values. Okay, as you can see, spline, the value at this intermediate point is greater than the value at this point. P-chip doesn't allow that to happen. All the values in the intermediate point strictly are below this value and above this value. Okay, that is other reason why when the speed is 0 and 0 over here, we get this flat line using the P-chip interpolation, because P-chip ensures that the monotonicity is maintained. So let's go to PowerPoint and finish what we started off with. So what we did in today's lecture is we considered two popular interpolation techniques, spline interpolation and p-chip interpolation, and we demonstrated that using two examples. The first one was temperature variation during a day. In this particular example, we were happy with what the spline interpolation gave us. In this particular example, we had a constraint that the speed is not going to fall below zero, and p-chip was therefore found to be more suitable because p-chip maintains the monotonicity in the data. So that's primarily what we have covered in this particular lecture. This is the last lecture of module 6. Just to recap very briefly what we did in module 6, in lecture 6.1, we went through introduction of regression and interpolation. In lecture 6.2 and 6.3, we covered several examples of regression techniques, linear as well as non-linear regression techniques using MATLAB. In today's lecture, we have covered two specific interpolation techniques. Those were spline interpolation and p-chip interpolation. So with that, we come to the end of module 6. I will see you next week. In the next week, in module 7, we are going to cover ordinary differential equations. So see you in the next week. Thank you.